Hello, everyone. Welcome to Acer Euro University from the two faculty of Social Science and Economics and Business Administration and Tourism. I would like to give you a teaching video clips in the subject of Core English 1B. And this subject is an English study for all students in business skill in the two faculties. And the clip now is about Unit 10, The Great Adventure. And this first video clip is about lesson A or part one that cover about listening, start, vocabulary, and grammar. Unit 10, Great Adventures. In this unit, you will learn to talk about explorers and expedition, discuss camping trips and equipment, shop for camping equipment, and also learn a grammar called the passive voice. So first, everyone, look at vocabulary that I made for you and translation for you, translated for you. Okay, so now let's have a look with me about the vocabulary, and I will read the English word, and you can look at the translation. Okay, đầm nào song phêng tỏ cha, Great Adventures. Okay, vocabulary from Unit 10. Nouns, access, backpack, biography, cable car, camping, caravan, civilization, compass, cruise, donkey, ride, emergency, equipment, expense, expedition, explorer, ferocity, first aid kit, gondola, hiking boots, injury, interior, map, match, merchant, missionary, pen, pilgrimage, pot, region, root, sandstorm, scenery, sewing kit, sickness, silk, sleeping bag, sleeping pad, sauce, storm, stove, tent, trail, waterproof jacket, whistle, adjective, one word only, ancient, verbs and verb phrases, be lost, blow, disappear, get lost, heat, hike, keep warm, light, recover, repair, sail, set off, set sail, expression. And guess what happened then? Have you heard of shop for camping equipment? How can I help you? I'm looking for, it has to be, let me ring you up. Sounds good. That looks good. That sounds good. What about this one? What kind of? Okay, so everyone now go to the lesson all together. Here, look at lesson A, start, expedition. So we have a reading. So now let's read about this one with me all together. In this reading, I will play the recording script for you and also show you the translation. So please, listen with me all together.
Unit 10, page 114, exercise 2. Marco Polo, 1254 to 1324, the son of a merchant, was born in Venice. With his uncle and father, He left home in 1271 and traveled overland to China, a route that became known as the Silk Road. He finally returned to Italy 25 years later.
David Livingstone, 1813 to 1873, a Scottish explorer and doctor, explored much of Central Africa. In 1866, he set out to look for the source of the Congo River. He never came back. During his travels, Livingstone visited many places where no European had been before.
Christopher Columbus, 1451 to 1506, wanted to discover a new route to India. He believed the quickest route was to sail west from Europe. He set sail in 1492 and arrived in the area now known as the Americas on October 12th. He thought he had arrived in India.
Okay, now you have listened and also watched the reading and also with translation already. So go back to exercise. Okay, so look at exercise 3, match 3 explorers to their expedition maps. Okay, A, David Livingstone, B, Marco Polo, okay, 3, Christopher Columbus. So 1, 2, and 3. And the tag is A, B, or the map is A, B, and C. So now put the map A with number 1, number 2, or number 3, B with number 1, number 2, or number 3, C with number 1, number 2, or number 3. Yes. And then show me when you meet me next week about that answer and learn to talk to me why you choose each map with the number. Okay, so please go to exercise 4. Think of one of the explorers you name in exercise 1. Tell a partner as much about this, about his or her story as you can. Okay, for example, have you ever heard of Zhang He? No, I haven't. B, well, he was the Chinese explorer who led an expedition in the 1400s too. This is an example for you in speaking. You can talk about explorer by using this sample. Okay, so now go to listening exercise. We have the listening that there are two people talking about the expedition to Lhasa. So what is Lhasa? Do you know that? Okay, before listening, what do you know about Tibet? Where is it? What famous mountain is located there? So search about that and tell me on the conference day. So before listening, look at this one. Focus on what you understand. When listen, don't focus on what you don't understand. It's okay to not understand everything. Focus on what you do understand, okay? Bây giờ dừng snap, dừng cùng khóa là riêng để dừng ở dùl. Cái ở dừng khóa là riêng nào để dừng dùl bản này nhé. Okay, so when you listen, after you listen, don't forget to choose exercise here. Choose the correct exercise. And one also have done for you as an example. Like, what did Alexandra David Neal come from? So A, Tibet, B, France, C, Asia. And the correct answer is B. How about the rest? Okay, so the rest from question two until 5. Choose the answer that is correct, but choose the answer only after you have listened. Okay, so now listen, everyone, and remember that in your listening I will show the text and also the translation for you so that you can understand better. Here the listening script. Okay, so let's listen now.
Page 115, Exercise 2.
And radio listeners, if you've just joined us, we're discussing some great stories from a new book called Female Explorers of the 19th and 20th Centuries. Can you tell us about any women who traveled to Asia, Marcia?
Yes, Gary. One amazing woman was Alexandra David-Néel, a French explorer born in Paris in 1868. Have you heard of her?
Well, no, I have to admit that I haven't, Marcia.
Alexandra David-Néel was born in Paris on October 24th, 1868. As a young woman, she was very interested in Asia and Asian languages. So when she was given some money as part of an inheritance, she decided to use it to fulfill one of her great ambitions, to travel to Tibet. Now, at that time, Tibet was forbidden to foreigners, closed to people from other countries. David-Néel tried to make the journey into Tibet four times, but each time she was discovered and sent back. In 1924, she decided to try again. This time, she traveled with her adopted Tibetan son, Yongden. They carried food, a knife to cut firewood, a tent, and leather to repair their boots. They traveled at night. During the day, they hid so that no one would see them. On their trip, they had many adventures. 4 months later, they reached Lhasa, the capital city of Tibet. Now they had one last problem. How could they enter the city without being seen?
And what did they do?
Well, Gary, suddenly, while they were thinking of a plan, a sandstorm began. It covered Lhasa, and everyone rushed into their houses for protection. This was their opportunity, and they entered the city. They had arrived. David-Néel and Yongden spent 2 months in Lhasa. They visited the famous Potala Palace and enjoyed the festival celebrating the Tibetan New Year. They were very worried that they might be discovered and ordered to leave, so they told no one who they really were. When finally it was time to go, they left the city as quietly and secretly as they had arrived. Now they had another long journey to India and home.
And I bet that after that trip, all she wanted to do was get home, have a long hot bath, and set off again.
You're absolutely right, Gary. David-Néel continued traveling in Asia for years and wrote many books about her adventures. She died in 1969 at the age of 101.
Years old, she can leave. Okay, and I'm here. Stop. How you know? My young, I tell her some light barney. Don't mean it. Complete her as a black high. So, behind him, let me talk to Anna. Okay, so can you number the story in order? This is the summary of the listening that talking between. Korea and Marcia, okay? So, yes, her name, the lady, her name is, can you know that? Yeah, Marcia, yeah, Marcia. Her name, Marcia. So the listening between Marcia and Korea are summarized here. So put them in order. Number one, David-Néel received some money. How about number two, number three, until number six, okay? So when you know, this is the kind of conversation strategy, okay? So whenever you want to show your interest, what you need to do to keep your listener interested when you are telling a story, ask questions like, and guess what happened then, and have you ever heard of, okay?
ຈັ່ງ
expression dani. And guess what happened then? Or have you ever heard of? Okay. I'm talking about smart work. I mean, ban club lưu nâng tí. Có bạn đàn đấy. Okay. Okay, now we go to exercise 4 about speaking exercise again. With a partner, ask and answer these questions. 1. What are some of the challenges for a woman traveling alone today? Was it more or less difficult for women travel alone in the past? Why? Okay, this question you can ask each other and tell your answer to your friend. This is kind of speaking exercise, okay? And question 2, who would you travel with if you were going on adventure vacation? Why? In your opinion, was travel more or less exciting in the past? Explain. Now we learn vocabulary. We have a number of picture here. A to N. And we have number 1 to number 14. So what you need to complete is that choose a letter from here to complete by the name given before the number, like 10 with number, with letter I here, 10 with letter I. Okay, so how about bed? How about sleeping bed? Pet, I'm sorry, sleeping pet. How about stove? Matches? Hiking boots? Pants? Waterproof jacket? A first aid kit? Sewing kit, a map, a compass, a whistle, and the last one is backpack. Okay. But to improve, to practice your pronunciation, I will play this reading for you. Okay. So let's listen with me all together. And then I have some document translated for you. The document here also translate for you. Essential for a camping trip. Okay.
Page 116, exercise 2. Essentials for a camping trip.
If you're going on a camping trip, here's a guide for several things you're going to need. Most important is a good tent.
1.
You'll also need a sleeping bag.
2. K.
And a sleeping pad.
3. N.
To put under the sleeping bag because it can get very cold at night. Hot food and drinks are another great way to keep warm. For this, you'll need a stove.
4. F.
For cooking and some pots and pans.
5. J.
For heating food and water. Don't forget to take matches.
6. L.
To light the stove. If you're going to be hiking a lot, you'll certainly need a good pair of hiking boots.
7. B.
A waterproof jacket.
8. M.
Will also be very important when the weather is bad. What about emergencies? A first aid kit.
9. G.
Is very important for injuries or sickness. And a sewing kit.
10. C.
Can be used to repair clothes. Many problems are caused by getting lost, so take a map.
11. H.
And a compass.
12. D.
Also bring a whistle.
13. E.
In an emergency, blow it 6 times. And finally, you need a good backpack.
14. A.
To carry all of this in.
Okay, did you hear well, everyone? Did you hear well? So I hope you get the answer from 1 to 14. One already, I have about 2. If you are not sure, you can play again. Or you can look at the picture from here before you listen. You can do like that. Okay, now imagine you are going on a camping in the mountain for a week. You can take only 8 of the items of equipment. Make a list of 8 items you choose. Okay. So everyone learn about English Express. Get lost means the process of losing your way. Be lost, it means the state of not knowing where you are. Dân get lost mình nên thay dân vùng viễn. Là về be lost có bởi về vùng viễn đấy. Bần tay này khó khăn nhất rằng thả. Get lost cứ dân rộp lợi thường. Là be lost mình nên thay dân phèng mong lên vùng viễn phèng lên sổ lời đúng không? Okay. Look at example. I got completely lost in the woods. I'm completely lost. Where's the trail? Something like this. Okay, now we learn grammar. The passive. I also have a paper, a page about grammar. So let's look with me and listen to my explanation. Okay, the passive. We can translate prayog rong amper. So when we use the passive, okay? Use the passive in narrative, or we call a story. When you want to make the object of a sentence into the subject, okay? Dương ai mớ, nha, dương pra prayog rong amper, nông ca này tiên rương, phía chán dương pra sẽ mẹ tiên rương, nha. Someone took John to the hotel. Now the pay young to the passive, young John to the subject pin. John was taken to a hotel by someone. Okay. So you can see John and then John. One is in the object, we call active sentence, and passive object become the subject. So when we use that, everyone, there are 3 things you need to remember when you want to use the passive voice. So use the passive voice when the agent. What is the agent? Can be person, can be thing that does the action is not known. Cứ nơi bây giờ nẹ bởi bật. Agent dựng bỏ bài phần nghe các bạn đưa nẹ bởi bật các bạn. Nẹ bởi bật đại miên được chỉ mình đúc, được chỉ vật thốt, đại thuốc sẽ cầm hiệp. Mình tự bàn cái đằng. Chẳng cái đăng thần này là thư. Nhưng cái bài phát xíu. Chúng ta đăng hay tại vì mình dùng khăn. When the agent isn't important. Vì mình dùng khăn. Hay trong cái cứ when the speaker is not more interested in the object of the active sentence. Meaning that I'm going to say that I'm going to say that I'm going to say that I'm passive wing. Because I'm going to say that 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 I'm passive. I'm going to say that I'm going to say that. Okay, right. I'm going to say that I'm going to say that. Okay. Agent is not known. My backpack was stolen last night. Agent not important. Agent isn't important or is not important. The important is my bag, you see. My bag was checked at the airport. I don't care about who checked my bag. But I just want to tell you that my bag was checked. Okay. And one more thing, speaker is interested in the object. The important thing is the in-car trail, not the people. Okay. Here, the in-car trail is traveled by many people. So how to make passive, everyone? The passive is formed using the auxiliary verb be plus past participle. Jung pay on per young on per and be bogan past participle. Jung passive comes along to passive past ten. Passive at your ten acre bar. She present, she past the future. Can I present? Yeah. A whistle is blown when a hiker is lost. Young is not good present, the blown is past participle. John was taken to the hotel by someone. And it past passive. Jung cognitron is and was. Can I is the present, was the past. Jung to make some kind of cognitron is and was. We did will be. That time will the nung verb be. Verb be young lane pra m is a the high, or was word the high, good young pra be. Pro pra will come down, young. The robber will be arrested soon. Okay? I like to know the yoke strop, yokes and no, my dad. The yoke strop, good young pra tomadan, young, good verb to be, bogan past participle. Young, my suitcase was checked at the airport by the custom. My suitcase was not checked at the airport by the custom. Was my suitcase checked at the airport by the custom? Like this. This is question, everyone. Question. Question mark. Okay. Because it's question, so we have to add question mark. Okay. Question mark. Note, everyone, when with the passive form, we can use by plus noun if we want to say who does the action. Dân 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 bánh mến, dân dây tha. Bây giờ active, bây giờ thua ẩm pơ, bây giờ passive, bây giờ rộng ẩm pơ. Ta bây giờ passive ai cho rộng nè, thua ẩm pơ bàn, bàn, tao dân pra bài, pra bài bộ ngang nào, ưu thế họ. We were questioned by the immigrant officer. Dân trở bán xua nóm đáy, mình tới là tao bộ về. Thế nhé, cái bài này. Ok, nhân cao vô gà mơ nhóm, miên tập bản năng tế. Bà nè đọc nè miên trường ngó, complex xuống nhóm khăn telegram của bạn, để chụp tỏa đến khăn e-learning của bạn nè. Ok, bây giờ đi nhanh cho lao chung nhật lập nè, chỉ lệch. Lấy dương lập mơ mơ miên trường quýnh nè đọc nè. Ok, look at exercise one, look at the picture, circle a sentence that describes each picture. We have one, two, three, and we have a pair of sentence. You need to choose only one. The woman was kissed by the baby. The woman kissed the baby. Which one is correct? Two, a man was bitten by a dog or the man bit the dog. Three, the girl was eaten by the fish or the girl ate the fish. So A or B, which one is correct? So look at the sentences in exercise one are examples of active and passive voice. So which sentence is active? Which sentences are active? Which sentences are passive? You put number like one, two, three, something like this. So in active voice sentence, the subject, a woman, does the action. In passive voice sentences, the subject, the baby received the action. Subject plus B plus main verb. Main verb, we have to make it past participle, or we call verb three. Look at the example. The woman kissed the baby. The baby was kissed by the woman. Okay. Now, everyone, do this exercise. The following are sentences. The following sentences are written in active voice. Rewrite the sentences in the passive voice. Pay attention to the verb tense in the active voice when forming the passive. Chẳng kéo dưỡng sẽ xe bởi dụng tầng này, tôi chỉ passive win, bởi dụng sẽ active nữa. Bởi ta xong chạp bảo rõm từ lời tense. Bởi cái past đã mà past, bởi cái present đã mà win present nữa. Chẳng complex thơ bởi dụng này, tôi chỉ passive. Tổng áo miễn bởi mũi, tại cái thơ ở mũi hay nó sao? Làm tiệt, chẳng này là thơ 200 chục như nữ. Conference. Talk about it. This is speaking exercise, everyone. With a partner, ask and answer this question. Answer in the passive voice. Don't forget to answer in the passive voice. For example, number one, who founded Microsoft? Who founded Microsoft? I think Microsoft was founded by Bill Gates, like that. And then two, who invented the light bulb? Who developed the theory of relativity? E plus E equal MC3, two, okay? Which country make up North America? Which countries make up North America? Who taught you English? Okay. Who was influenced the most in your life? Okay, so this is question, and then you can answer with your own way. Okay. Now. We finished part one video, and I hope everyone pay most attention to my lecture. Okay, it's the end of my first teaching video clip. And thank you for watching and wait for the final part, lesson B. Thank you so much. Bye-bye for now.